This week on the Internet Cafe, find anyone or anything on the net. This lady is a librarian, but forget the Dewey Decimal System. She's now organizing the content on the web. Check out mapblast.com for driving directions to any place in the country. Planet All is a website that helps you find old friends and colleagues. This woman has started WooWoo Women, a new search engine catering to the needs of female net surfers. And if you want to resolve that movie trivia argument, you'll find the answer here at the Internet Movie Database. Finding what you want on the web, next on the Internet Cafe.
The Internet Cafe is brought to you by Z Auction, the live online shopping experience.
Additional funding from PC Connection and Mac Connection, the catalog and online superstore with PC and Mac products, toll-free technical support and overnight delivery. And by Windows Magazine, delivering desktop, enterprise and internet computing news, reviews, features and how-tos for a Windows world, because the world runs on Windows.
So, do you have the same problem I do? I mean, it's so difficult finding what you're looking for on the web.
I don't even know what I'm looking for on the web.
So that's the solution to that one.
Not a problem.
All right.
But tonight I'm going to talk to some folks from Planet All.
And, a good site.
This is an interesting site. It's I think you'd probably call it a community site.
An affinity site, I think.
Right. You actually enter in all your information, your statistics, and you find, and you're linked with other people who are maybe went to the same high school,
right.
Joined the same church, joined the same groups as you, and you can track them, you can talk with them, you can share calendars.
So rather than finding strangers, the old sort of chat, you know, community model, this is really finding people who you already know in some way.
Right, exactly.
What are you doing?
Map Blast.
Map Blast. Is this a game?
I can get you to where you need to go.
What is it?
It is basically it's a website where you can go and get directions, or give directions.
So find geographic
from
stuff.
Your house to someone else's, or you're having a party, you want everybody to get to your place, you can email them a map to your house.
I've used that.
You can find out where the local Macy's is, you can do it all.
All right, I'm going to do two things. I'm talking to a lady who's a librarian who actually will say that there's a search engine with a human being at the other end that can really help you find what you're looking for. That's what I want. And then a great thing called the Internet Movie Database, which is really cool. Something I've always, well, you know, you sort of have an idea. You saw some movie about something 30 years ago or 20 years ago and you can't remember. You can actually track it down by plot, by quotes. It's really cool.
By quotes?
Yeah, yeah.
Wow.
So, like, you know, who said that in what movie? You know, if you get into an argument in a bar over...
Okay, here's one.
Movie. Are you talking to me?
Are you talking to me?
What's the movie?
Taxi Driver.
We'll find out. Okay. All right. Who, what, where, when? How can you find it on the web coming up on the Internet Cafe?
It was Taxi Driver.
Yeah.
Oh. So, Amrik, you're the president of Vicinity, and now you've got this great website called MapBlast.com, which, by the way, I've been using for the last couple of years since I travel so much, trying to get directions. So this is near and dear to my heart. For those people who haven't been to MapBlast, what are some of the things that they can do at your website?
Well, the primary reason that MapBlast was created by Vicinity was to really as a place that people go on the web. If you are not familiar with a particular neighborhood, you can type in an address and we'll automatically build a map for you. Once that map has actually been generated, again, in your web browser, you don't have to do anything special to do it. You can either print the map out and take it with you, but you can also email it to a friend if you'd like to. So if you're having a party and you want to send all your friends directions to your house, go to MapBlast, type in the address, out comes a map. Email it to them, and you're all done.
So those are great, because I remember days of trying to draw my map to my house and so on. Now, the interesting thing about that is you can actually give them the map from their house to your house. Is that right?
That's right. There's another feature. There are actually four major features that we can provide. The first we've already talked about is just a basic map of the neighborhood that you're in. But suppose you want to give them actually turn-by-turn directions. You know, take, you know, if you're here in the San Francisco area, take, you know, Highway 101 to the San Antonio Road exit. We can give you those in a fair amount of detail. We can also provide to people who visit our site what we call Yellow Pages, which are exactly the same as Yellow Pages in your phone book, except one very nice twist. Instead of giving you one hotel, we can give you the 10 closest hotels, something that we call proximity searching within geographic that's geographically close to where you live. And the last piece is for if you're looking for specific businesses, for example, let's say for Federal Express, which is one of our customers, we can show you where the nearest Dropbox is. Once again, we can give you the same turn-by-turn directions from your home to wherever the nearest Dropbox is.
So it's actually neat, because if you've moved to a new place and you don't know the area, the Yellow Pages feature actually allows you to kind of get a snapshot of all the various services, and it's organized by type. So you've got entertainment, or you've got art galleries, or you've got basic shopping and that type of thing, basically.
That's exactly right. I mean, if you look at, you know, one of our larger customers, which is Yahoo, so every time you go to the Yahoo website, it's actually, you know, Vicinity who's actually providing the maps, you know, the drive and directions. And actually, the thing that most people go there for is actually their Yellow Pages.
Right.
So for hotels, for, you know, movie theaters, for whatever, you can click on one of those again, you know, within your web browser, and we'll actually bring you back all the locations we can find, and then generate, again, turn-by-turn directions from your home to wherever the specific business is.
Now, what's the future hold for MapBlast? What are some of the things that you're going to be doing with that technology?
Well, I think one of the things we've really tried to focus on is really trying to provide one seamless experience. Let's suppose that, I mean, you and your significant other want to go out for a great evening on the town. You say, I want to go to downtown San Francisco. So we can generate to you where all the nearest restaurants are.
Right.
We can show you where, you know, the movie theater is. And you say, but by the way, I also need to get a tux, and I need to find the nearest ATM. We can also put that on your map as well. So it isn't finding for a specific location, but really it's about an experience, an evening, you know, out in the town, or it could be, you know, going for, you know, a picnic, or it could be almost anything. It could be things like, for example, I'm driving between LA and San Francisco. You know, show me all the Shell stations along the way and also all the Marriott hotels.
So you name it, you can cover the whole thing.
We can do it all for you.
The biggest pain in the neck on the internet is trying to find what you're looking for. So I'm really looking forward to meeting the woman who's sitting over here, because she is an expert on searching the internet. And Carol, you're a librarian, so I guess that's a pretty good background for somebody who tries to make sense out of that maze of infinite information out there on the web.
It is, and I love doing it. It just drives me.
All right, now, good. I need your help. I think everybody needs your help. Let's start there. We start usually, the default is you go to a search engine. You go to a Yahoo or an Excite or an AltaVista, something like
right.
that. Why don't they do a better job? Why do you get back all these endless things that don't really relate to what you're looking for?
Because what you're searching is something that's put together by a computer. And the old adage, garbage in, garbage out, those search engines have a software program that goes out and tries to index every web page they can find on the internet. There's 120 million web pages out there. Their databases have maybe 50, 55 million of those pages in there. You do a search, you put in some words, well, it goes through and it throws back those words at you.
So you're saying it's kind of a stupid search. There's no real intelligence involved.
People, if they know how to use the search engines, can get much better results. They need to read the help pages on the search
mm-hmm.
engines. But to save time, one of the best things to do is to use what's called a subject directory. Yahoo's the best known of them. They have about 400,000 or so.
So you're saying Yahoo is different from an automatic search engine. It is a subject directory. So somebody has looked at stuff and thought about this?
Humans have looked at things and tried to put them in order. Human beings. That's
librarians.
The difference. And the librarians index to the internet, which is the index that I work on, that's also a searchable index, has been looked at, and websites have been looked at by librarians, evaluated. We pick the ones we think are the most useful to people. We categorize them. We apply subject headings to them that may not even be in the web page that's indexed,
mm-hmm.
but a term that somebody might look for, like cost of living. Someone wants to find cost of living. But the web page says salary calculator.
Yeah.
They're never going to get it from a search engine. It'll never come up.
All right, so let me understand. If I go to this website, this internet index that you librarians have put together, what do I find there? How is it different from just going to an Excite or an AltaVista?
You find there a list of categories, which isn't that much different from some of the big search engines, but when you click on those lists of categories, what you get are summarized, annotated by human beings,
mm-hmm.
not from the first 20 words in the web pages, lists of what's useful on this topic. If I want to search people, here's a good list of biographical sources.
Yeah.
If I want to find out about bird watching, here's a good list.
But do you have enough human beings to do all this? I mean, isn't that why they use computers to do this? Because there's a million things out there?
You need both. You really do need both. You can start your search with the subject directory. If you want to take that approach, if you have a general thing you're looking for, you start there.
Mm-hmm.
If you have a very specific piece of information, I want to find out about the Temple of Alexandria.
Okay.
If you know how to put that search into a search engine, like Temple of Alexandria is a good example.
Right.
If you type those words in, you're much less likely
to get
relevant information than if you put quotes around those three words and made it a phrase. That's
you have like advice
thing.
Like this on, I mean, search tips at your site?
At my site, there's a tips page. There's a little link you can click on called Recommended Search Tools. It brings up the biggies. It brings up AltaVista, InfoStick, all on one page with little hints for each one right there. You can pop in a search, go there. Oh, it doesn't work. Hit your back button, go back, copy that same search into another search engine, go find it. It's really efficient. And that's what we're about, is to how to help people get to that information that we think is probably out there.
Is there a way to actually get a human being to help you when you're really stuck anywhere?
Yeah, there's a couple of projects going on right now that you might not know about. The Internet Public Library, operated out of the University of Michigan, they actually have a MOO, a multi-user oriented place where you can go and you can ask the librarian a question and you will get back information
that's
via
what
email.
I want Carol to help me find
email.
This stuff.
Yeah.
All right, let's go take a look at this.
So Jody, you're from a company called Planet All, and it sounds like it's a company built sort of to find people. I had an interesting story. I had a friend, a college roommate, lost touch with him for a couple years, and then all of a sudden got a call one night. He found me on the internet. Now, he found me through a search engine and got my email address. How does Planet All differ, and what's it all about?
Well, Planet All is a free internet service. You can find it on www.planetall.com. Mm-hmm. And what's different about Planet All is that some of these other search engines and directories, if you know exactly who you're looking for, you can search on them.
Right.
And often what happens is the information's out of date.
Mm-hmm.
What Planet All is doing for you is giving you an updated address book that will never go out of date. And what it also does is allows you to look in different affinity groups, your employer, where you went to college, where you went to high school, interest groups you belong to, and find people through that mechanism.
Okay, now I went on last night and I actually did find, I think, 10 people that I was, not that I knew, but that I went to high school with, 10 people from college, and actually one guy who works in my department at work. So I was able to actually go up and say, hey, I saw you last
night. Absolutely.
So what is the information that I'm sharing that I can share with these people?
So what you do is when you find those people, you link to them.
Mm-hmm.
And once you establish that link with people, they're in your address book. If you change jobs or you move or you get a new address, it's going to inform all those people that you're linked to of that information. So
okay.
No one will ever lose track of you again.
So this is a way to keep touch with people that you maybe don't have time to call or you've just lost touch with over the years? Or
absolutely. You know, in today's busy world, we have a hard time staying in touch. And Planet All does all that work for you.
Okay.
Once you join those groups and you establish those links, the information is fed to you in a daily email. And it'll tell you whose birthday's coming up, what events are coming up in the affinity groups you belong to.
Now, isn't this a little scary? I mean, in a sense, we don't have to call anybody anymore. We don't even have to talk to anybody anymore.
Well, the great thing about it is it does all the hard work for you, and it makes it really easy for you to have face-to-face contact with people. For instance, if you and I are going to be in New York next week, and it'll tell us that we're going to be crossing paths and we can have lunch together.
So basically our calendars are in there as well, and it's telling us when our calendars are in the same place?
Right. The only thing you have to do is update your own personal information, which is where you're going to be,
right.
And also what your personal information is, where you live, and that type of thing. But the great thing about it is that you get to choose who sees what information.
Okay, because I was going to say, the one thing that this sounds like is you are sharing information, or potentially could share information, that you don't want
right.
everybody to know. So how do you deal with that?
And that's one thing that's different about us than a White Pages, is that a White Pages is very public, and
right.
a lot of people don't want that information publicized. The only people that are going to see your information are those that you decide to link to.
Okay.
And again, you get to decide what information they actually
okay.
see.
Now, speaking of people you decide to link to, you mentioned affinity groups. What are some of the types of affinity groups that are
sure.
that are in this?
Sure. It's we have about 60,000 affinity groups
wow.
in Planet All, none of which we created. They were all created by our users.
Okay.
And it ranges anywhere from the high school you went to, the college,
mm-hmm.
the clubs you belong to, fraternities, sororities.
Workplace.
Exactly.
Are religions in there and things like that as well?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Everything you can think of
wow.
is in there.
Wow.
And the other thing that's nice about it is that the affinity group you are in isn't in Planet All yet. You can create that group and encourage others to join.
Very good. So now, what is the future of a site like this? It sounds like you're doing everything you could possibly do. If you're sharing calendars, sharing email addresses, what's left? Basically going out on dates with each other, maybe. What?
Well, the great thing about Planet All is that we're encouraging people to stay in touch.
Mm-hmm.
And once we have the rest of the world in Planet All, Everyone is going to be able to stay in touch a lot easier.
Right.
The other thing that's really nice about it is that we make any other contact manager that you currently have much more powerful because it is dynamic and it's always updated. So you'll never have that problem of sending out Christmas cards and having them come back because the address is incorrect.
Wow. Okay. Well, I'm going to have to run out and get a new address book and link to Planet All.
I hope you do.
All right, Bob, we're trying to find out how to find information on the web, and you're involved in a specialized area, the Internet Movie Database. Why is it considered the best movie database on the web?
Well, we have the most information of any site. We have close to 120,000 movies and close to 500,000 people represented in the database, movies from like the late 19th century up to, you know, movies that haven't been released yet.
Well, it's interesting, you're not really a corporate site though, right? You're just a bunch of guys around the world who love movies.
Exactly right. We're about 17 guys around the world plus, you know, untold thousands of fans who contribute data and have been contributing since the late 80s when this started as sort of a grassroots thing.
So if I go onto IMDb and I'm looking for information, what does it look like? What can I search for?
You can search for all kinds of things. The main searches, of course, are searches for actors and actresses or directors or writers. But there's also text searches on movie quotes, which
is my
specialty.
So you're the quotes guy. Now, what is that? In other words, if I remember somebody in a movie said, frankly, Scarlett, I don't give a damn, and I don't remember what the name of the movie was, I can go and actually search on a quote like that?
Yeah, exactly. You type in, frankly, Scarlett, or I don't give a damn, and up would come Gone with the Wind, plus probably half a dozen imitator movies.
And what are the most popular quotes that people find, actually?
Everyone searches for, I'll be back.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Well, any others?
Let's see. Everyone wants to know about half a dozen different quotes from Casablanca.
Casablanca, of course.
It's one of the most popular ones.
Right.
For some reason, any Spielberg movie.
Huh.
And then, of course, there are all the Clint Eastwood quotes
and the
Arnold Schwarzenegger quotes.
All right, now let me ask you, what I really want to find out is plot stuff. I'm always thinking, is there a movie? It seems to me there's a story somewhere about, you know, a guy marries a girl and they take a horse and they go out to Arizona and they open a drugstore and I can't remember what the movie is. Can I actually search by storyline?
Sure you can. We've got plot summaries in the database, also contributed by the, the fans. And you can text search them. You type in Arizona and horse and married.
So I can do that now.
Sure you can.
All right. Now, you're doing this. You get cooperation from Hollywood for this, or they sort of don't like what you're doing?
Well, originally they were a little standoffish. We were trying to do some promotional deals with them. But we're not affiliated with anybody. We're not corporate. We're totally independent.
And they have their own websites, and you're stealing business.
Exactly. The studios have their own websites where they promote their own movies. But I think we've sort of gained some cachet in the last year or 2 years.
So you're big enough now that they need to work with you.
Yeah, we're starting to get some cross-promotional deals with the studios.
And these guys who were probably battling you were probably using your database and not telling you anyhow, right?
Well, everyone who works at the studios, you know, sort of uses the IMD for all their research.
Now, I think your big competition would be something like the Microsoft Cinemania CD-ROM, which is a pretty good source of that stuff, too. But yours is better.
Well, ours is better because we're constantly updating the database. We have hundreds or possibly even thousands of new titles and people and quotes and all the other information updated every single week.
Yeah.
And you just can't keep up with that on a CD-ROM.
So it's the net, it's live, and you got all these people around the world, you know, fixing it up.
Exactly.
All right, now let me ask you, why do most people go to the database? I mean, these aren't researchers, really. Are they trying to solve a trivia bet or something?
Usually it's trivia bets, yeah. And we get a lot of email from people saying, I got to know this, you know, otherwise I'm
going
to have to do a month of chores or something like that.
All right, now, in this quotes area, how did you get involved in this?
I've always liked movie quotes, good pithy movie quotes, and I've collected them for, forever. And in the late 80s, I discovered the Internet Movie Database, and I started using it to supplement my quotes collection. Finally, I decided, I've got so many quotes collected, I really ought to contribute them back. Well, the timing was great, because the guy who was maintaining the quotes list then, a fellow named Lars, said, boy, am I glad you came along. I've got to go do my mandatory military service. I need someone to take over the quotes list.
So this is a labor of love, not a business yet?
It's a business, of course. We have advertising on our site, but it started out as a labor of love, and it still is. When the decision to go commercial was made, there was initially a lot of internal resistance to it.
This is the web, this is the net, it's people.
Yeah, it's sort of contrary to the spirit of the whole thing. But we've sort of kept it out of the face of the users, pretty much.
Yeah.
The data is still all free.
Okay, it's called imdb.com.
That's right.
Thanks, Bob.
Thank you.
So Kathleen, you have a site that the title is WW Women. Do you pronounce it Women or how do you say it?
No, we actually do say it WW Women.
Okay,
it's like the play of the WW of the web.
Okay, so I got it right.
Right.
Well, I have a question. My mother is an insomniac. The other day she said to me, what is this internet thing? I hear people stay up all night and talk to each other. Can I get on there? And I said, well, I don't know if I just want to turn her loose on the web. It may be too big for her to just, you know, sort of get her feet wet. Is this a site that she could go to and find some interesting things relating to her?
It's really good for that because in many ways, a lot of people go to Yahoo first. But women can go to this search directory first and look up keywords that are related to insomniac or what other interest she has and be able to search up sites that would be good information for her.
Okay, now how does that differ, though, from a Yahoo or something like that? Are you also having more sites that are related specifically to women's issues and things like that?
Yeah, we have guidelines and we have people who check every single link that goes into the directory to make sure that it's related to women's issues.
So there's actually a dedicated staff that's checking these sites. What are some of the criteria that you have to pass to be on this?
Well, some of the criteria are self-evident. So if you have a site on breast cancer, we know that's a women's issue.
Okay.
Some of them are not. For example, one that would feature women basketball players or women in business.
So women's sports is actually an emerging
It's a very broad women topic. In education, women in science. So there's a lot of categories for that.
A lot of different things. Okay, so once people find sites, find information, then what can you do on the site? I noticed there were some chat areas and other things like that. Is that popular?
Right. It's a great combination to have a search tool plus a sense of community. So once they find what they're looking for, they can also go to a message board and find other women and talk online. So
about the subjects they may have found.
Various subjects. We have over 50 message boards, and a lot of those are anything from relationship, again, to sports, work.
What are the most popular, I mean?
The relationships ones are. We do actually break them up.
I think men's would probably be very popular, too.
Right. Women love to talk, though.
Right.
They really do.
Okay,
and
so
we have, message boards for older women and some for younger women, and then, women in business and that type of thing.
Yeah. Now, actually, what this brings to my mind is that this is sort of an emerging demographic. I mean, I think when the web first started, I think there wasn't as many women online, but now, they say there's 50 million people or so online, and I think a big percentage of that is women. You may know. Do you actually know what a general percentage is that they think now?
I mean, some sources will quote 40% of the people are women, so it's certainly growing.
Right.
I think, in real life, women are a good portion of the population, and that's just starting to become more comfortable online. That the women are getting more comfortable with commerce. They love connecting with each other, so as they discover this, they're spending more time online.
Right.
I think it has a lot to do with that.
Right. Now, are you finding that advertisers are also interested in this new demographic?
They're just getting used to it, and they find that you can go on a targeted site like WW Women, and 97% of our visitors are women.
Really?
So it's a great way to reach that particular demographic.
Okay. Now, you say 97%, so there is still some things on here that may be of interest to
We're not men haters. Men are very welcomed on our site. They're very welcomed on our site.
Great.
Yeah.
Okay. So what would be some things that would be interesting for men as well? I mean, just...
Well, actually, a lot of the men look up the women basketball scores on our site.
Really?
Yes.
Wow.
So they like to keep track of the scores,
so
and they like to talk
popular.
To the women about their perspective on relationships. So there's been some good discussions in the message boards as well.
So you can kind of find out what the issues are. That makes very good sense.
Right. It's good to have their perspective.
Right. We'll go check it out.
Sounds great.
So, can you do a better job now finding what you want if you knew what you wanted on the web?
I still don't know what I want. But actually, this Planet All is a great site if you don't really know what you want.
Yeah.
You go in there and you enter your stuff, and I found all kinds of different
people. You actually use
it? Yeah, I did. And I found 10 people that I went to high school with, 10 people that I went to college with, and actually one person that I work with. And I can interact with them and start...
Do you really want to get in touch with these guys?
I don't know if I really want to. But,
well, it's safe on the
you.
Net anyhow.
Exactly.
It's not
exactly.
too bad. All right, so what about MapLess? What'd you learn there?
Well, I think for anybody who does a lot of traveling, this is a great site because you can get all the information, even some information you didn't know you were looking for about that particular location.
Mm-hmm.
So you go to a new city, you want to find out all the different restaurants, what's close to that particular area where your hotel is. You can get it all. It's great.
Yeah, it's funny how finding stuff on the web is, in a sense, the worst part of the web, yet when it works, in the two cases you
guys
talk about, it's the best part of the web.
I thought it was interesting, this lady librarian I talked to was really knocking a lot of the search engines, saying they're sort of these stupid robot kind of things, and that's why you get these 10,000 matches that don't do you any good. But there actually are sites where there are people involved who have thought about it and sort of organized this stuff, like the nice lady at the library would have done for you and actually help you find what you're looking for.
Right. Actually, the woman I talked to from
got a stuttering problem?
Exactly. They were actually doing that. They had people that went through and actually checked all the sites and made sure they were relevant and important, interesting information to people. So they were verifying the sites.
Hard to replace the good old human being. We're here to stay.
Although
web or no
some
web.
Of us will try.
All right, that's it for this edition of the Internet Cafe. We'll see you here next week.
The Internet Cafe is brought to you by Z Auction, the live online shopping experience.
Additional funding from PC Connection and Mac Connection, the catalog and online superstore with PC and Mac products, toll-free technical support and overnight delivery. And by Windows Magazine, delivering desktop, enterprise and internet computing news, reviews, features and how-tos for a Windows world, because the world runs on Windows.
To purchase a videotape copy of today's program, call toll-free 1-888-310-7850. Please specify show number and topic.